Hello folks and welcome to another opening of Mr. H's Art Prop. You join me today here in Dalton in Lancashire, which is sort of on the border of Lancashire and the Wigan Borough. It's in one of those funny places where it has a Wigan postcode, but it comes under West Lancashire. Now, we're at the ruins of Bellevue Farm, and as you can see, it's very overgrown here. And I'm at the west elevation of what would have been a rather impressive farmhouse. As always, I'll stick a stock photo on about now, and I'll circle roughly where we are on it. Now, this ruin has lain here, apparently, since about the 1930s, I believe. And the current owner of this land has wanted to rebuild this, and he's asked for permission, and they've turned him down. It seems to be a running theme, this, with councils, where there's like remote farmhouses that they want to rebuild. Local councils don't want them to put them back into a dwelling for some reason. I mean, I think it would look lovely here, this stone cottage, once again. As you can see, it's just fallen into disrepair, and you sort of have to feel sorry for the landowner, because he's just got a ruin on his hands, basically. So we'll take a little loop round this as best we can, but there's not really a lot to see. I believe there's a toilet over there, which I'll show you later, and that's about the best part of it. It's such a shame, because as you can see from this window here, there's been a bit of intricate work in it at one time, and at the front it used to have a very nice arched porch, but I believe all that's collapsed now. So we'll take a little loop round as best we can. I mean, we shouldn't really be here, because it's you're not supposed to be on here, but hey-ho. This would have been the front of the house, and as you can see here from this window, it's sort of lost its middle, that's sort of collapsed in. That porch I was telling you about, and what you would have seen on the photo, is just through there, hidden in that tree there. I mean, somebody's really got the work cut out here for trying and restore this. I believe all the stonework to it is all sort of stacked up, hidden amongst all these brambles. But yeah, you've really got your work cut out to put this back into a dwelling, I think. But fair play, why not? You know, if somebody's willing to put the money into it and restore an old building, let's face it, we've lost a lot of our heritage with one thing and another, so why not? Yeah, it's a pity really. I was hoping to be able to show you more of this, but it's just all overgrown, as you can see. I mean, there's obviously pathways through here, so somebody's coming through here on a regular basis, and where they lead, I don't know. And with it raining, I'm not going to push it too much, because Mrs. H has got Crocs on and she'll end up with wet feet, and she's already complaining that she's been stung with nettles and things a few times. You see, I know how to treat a lady, don't I? Anyway, we'll go and have a little look at that midden now, shall we? And as always, here's the toilet to Bellevue Farm. Now we'll take a little look inside. I mean, as you can see there, that seat, that would have been the midden. Somebody's filled that in, and it appears somebody's been living in there. There's quite a bit of paper and that stuff down there. I suppose you could sort of sleep on there. I wouldn't fancy it though. We're just going to head through the main gates here, which would have led into the farm. And they're still being used today because the footpath, the public footpath, runs straight through them. Whether they did originally or not, I don't know. You do find sometimes as public footpaths cross farmland. And what farmers like to do is have the dogs running loose in the farmyard. We've come up against that a few times. But seeing as this is a ruin, I doubt there'll be any dogs in here other than me own. Off we go. We'll just show you the inside of Bellevue Farmhouse now, or what's left of it. As you can see, there are very thick stone walls. Not really a lot of keying in. I don't know if this stone's locally quarried. I should imagine it would be, because you've got the cost of transporting it, which would have been horrendous back in them days. And you can just make out a wooden lintel above that window there in the west elevation. It looks like it's got a lot of woodworm in it too. Right, we'll push on and see what else we can see. I believe there was a stone barn to this as well. It might be down this path somewhere, so we'll see if we can find it. Well, we found the barn. I'm now sort of studying what would have been the entrance where. There's only this wall that remains still stood up. It would have been a flag floor. I mean, look at that there, that's a proper York stone there under me girls. I'm surprised they've still remained here and nobody's had them, as it's quite expensive, and there was a big run on it, wasn't there, at one time in the 90s, I think, for people wanting flagstone floors. But anyway, yeah, like I say, the poor fella who owns this, he's got his work cut out. They might have done him a favour, actually. They probably just got it built and then not lived to enjoy it. It would take that long. And I don't think you can get stonemasons now. There's not that many. You can name your own price if you're a stonemason. Something I always fancied having a go at, even though I'm a bricky by trade. But yeah, it's a bit out in the wilds, this. Be a long walk with your wheelie bin, wouldn't it, back to the main road. Now, these are original gate posts. We've seen these sort of things on many of our travels on local farm ruins. And once again, they've got the holes in, and they would have fitted a bar through there to keep cattle and trespassers out, type of thing. This now is just sort of leading into a bit of a field, so we're just going to go up a little bit further and see what we can see. As I said, there's not a lot here. I thought it would have been a bit more impressive than this. Well, there we have it, folks. That was Bellevue Farm. As I say, unfortunately, there's not a lot I can show you. A bit disappointing, really, but there you have it. As you can see, this is all that's left of it. So, we're going to get off now, and we're going to get back to the car and hopefully dry out a little bit. I'm hoping this rain does clear up a bit so I can get back on that shed for the father-in-law. So, until the next time, bye-bye for now.